Hi folks, CodeTutor here, and my name is Anil Deshpande. Welcome to another new video on Jetpack Compose. In the previous video, we have seen how to basically work with the theming concepts. You basically applied the typography, changed the color of the cards and the screens, and even changed the shape of the default surface buttons. Now it is time to move beyond this. In any typical application, one of the very common features that you would implement is when you click on a screen, you usually want to navigate to another screen. And in that screen, probably in this case, you want to show some information. This is a very typical navigation mechanism. In this case, we have a screen which can be called as country list screen. And when you click on the country list screen, you should be able to navigate to a country info screen. And if you click on back, which is typically available with the Android device, then you should be able to navigate back to the previous screen. Now, the obvious question that you would be thinking is, how do we do this? How to navigate from one screen to another screen? If you put a developer hat here, your mind would be buzzing with questions like how to navigate from one screen to another screen, how to control the navigation between the screens, how to pass the arguments from one screen to another screen. Can these screens be composable or fragments or activities? How does navigation work between them? Is there a stack of composables like activity stack or a fragment stack? Who manages the stack of composables? And probably a couple of more. So in the next couple of videos, we will basically discuss the navigation with Jetpack Compose in a very detailed manner. So let's start with a very clean slate. So let's assume that you have screen 1, screen 2, and screen 3. All of these screens can be built using composables, or it could be an activity or even a fragment. But right now, for simplicity purpose, since we are working with Jetpack Compose, we are only going to talk about composables as of now. So now, to understand the Jetpack navigation terminology, you will have to be familiar with certain jargon. And what are those jargon? NavHost, destination, NavController, action, and navigation graph. If I try to explain you right now what these are and how they work together to basically implement Jetpack navigation, you will become even more confused. So let's try to understand this through an analogy. And in this case, I will try to use an analogy of a tour. Let's start with the most simplest of these terminologies. The first one being destination. Well, in a tour, destination are basically the cities or the tourist spots that you would like to visit. And if I try to compare it with the programmable screens, destination are nothing but the screens. The screen 1, screen 2, screen 3 are basically the screens on which you want to land as a part of your application navigation. So that's the very first analogy. The next part is navigation host. Think of navigation host as a person, a tour guide, which is going to help you to visit all these destinations. And that navigation host basically works with navigation control. Think of navigation control as a kind of a map that navigation host uses to take you around various destinations. The next part is action. Well, think of action as a route between the destination. The nav host not only needs the map, the nav controller, to take you to the destination, he also needs to know the routes between the destinations. So think of these routes or actions are basically the decisions which tell you where you want to navigate in the actual application from one screen to another screen. That is what the action is. And the one component which basically binds all these things, that is NavHost, NavController, destination, and action, that is the NavGraph. Continuing with analogy of the tour, think of NavGraph as a ternary, which contains all the information. It contains the information about the destinations, NavHost, NavController, what are the routes that are supposed to be taken, that is action. Everything is mentioned in this one centralized place called as NavGraph. And with all these things together, you basically make your application's navigation work. In the next video, we will actually start writing the Jetpack navigation using all these concepts and libraries. So stay tuned for the next video.
That brings us to the end of this particular video. Don't forget to like, comment, share the video, and subscribe to the channel. Take care. Bye.